Video 3.2, Azure Device Provisioning Service. In this video, we will cover the following topics. Device Provisioning Service Overview, when to use DPS, provisioning process, and features of DPS. In the previous lecture, we learned that the Azure IoT Hub allows connecting IoT devices to the Azure Cloud to transmit and receive telemetry data between the IoT device and Azure Cloud. This is a great service, isn't it? But what happens if you have hundreds or even thousands of devices to register? Individually registering thousands of devices to the Azure IoT Hub would be a nightmare. Azure Device Provisioning Service is the solution to such a problem. Device Provisioning Service, abbreviated as DPS, is a helper service for Azure IoT Hub that helps to register IoT devices to the IoT Hub automatically, without any human intervention. DPS enables zero-touch and just-in-time provisioning of IoT devices to the right IoT hub. Millions of IoT devices can be provisioned in a secure and scalable way using DPS. From the discussion, it is clear that a common provisioning scenario in which DPS would be used is when you need to register multiple IoT devices to the Azure IoT hub automatically. There are many other situations in which DPS is an excellent choice for device provisioning to the IoT hub. Let us find out some. Automatic provisioning IoT devices to a single IoT solution. Load balancing devices across multiple IoT hubs. Reprovisioning an IoT device when a change is made on the device. Connecting devices to an IoT hub with the lowest latency. Connecting devices to a particular IoT solution depending on the use case. There are two steps involved in the provisioning process of the device. First is the manufacturing step, and the second is the cloud setup step. Let us find out how DPS takes part in process provisioning independently and simplifies the deployment process in these two distinct steps. In the manufacturing step, DPS is introduced on the manufacturing line. In the manufacturing process of the devices, a device ID is created for each device. But when DPS comes into action, instead of creating a device ID, the device is programmed with the provisioning information. The programmed device will get the connection information of the right IoT hub when switched on. In the manufacturing step, the manufacturer provides identifying key information, like a signing certificate, to generate X509 certificate or TPM endorsement key for each trusted platform module device. In the cloud setup step, the cloud is configured for automatic provisioning. In this step, the provisioning service is configured and the device is added to the enrollment list of the DPS. The device operator does the enrollment process. Enrollment list can be updated if new devices are added to the list or an existing device is updated. DPS registers the device with an IoT hub when required. Now that we have a rudimentary familiarity with Azure Device Provisioning Service, you may ask, what features of DPS make it ideal for provisioning devices? Let us discuss some of the key features of DPS here. Secure attestation. DPS supports both X509 and TPM-based identification of devices while establishing a connection with the Azure IoT Hub. Enrollment list. DPS has an enrollment list that contains the complete information of devices or groups of devices that may register to Azure IoT Hub. This list allows modifications at the device operator end. Multiple allocation policies. DPS has multiple allocation policies to control how DPS assigns devices to IoT hubs in different scenarios. Monitoring and diagnostics logging. DPS keeps on monitoring and maintains diagnostics logging to make sure that everything is working properly. Multi-hub support. DPS can assign devices to more than one IoT hub and allows communication between hubs across multiple Azure subscriptions. Cross-region support. DPS can assign devices to IoT hubs in other regions as well. Encryption and decryption. Data at rest in DPS can be encrypted and decrypted transparently. That is all, folks, for this video. We will see how to provision an IoT device to Azure IoT Hub using DPS further in this course. Video summary. In this video, we have covered the following topics: Device Provisioning Service Overview, when to use DPS, the provisioning process, and features of DPS. In the next video, we will learn about Azure Stream Analytics.